In this video, we're going to talk about the benefits and risks of Web3. You probably heard the term Web3 bandied about, but it's just arrived and it's here to stay. And it's going to change the way that you interact with the internet forever.
Obviously, nothing I say on this channel is financial advice. Always do your research before investing anyway.
Let's get into today's video. So what exactly is Web3? So traditional Web2 is basically where you can interact with the internet, where you can upload things yourself, like you can on Instagram and Facebook, where you can read different content, where you can buy things. The internet you've been basically using since Google and Facebook came about. Now that's all great, but actually you don't really have full ownership of all of the different things that you're uploading. So for example, this video that's uploaded onto YouTube now becomes the content of YouTube, and if YouTube wants to take it away, they can do that. However, Web3 is slightly different in that we are all then contributors to the internet and we'll all have freedom to upload and do whatever we want on the internet, which obviously comes with its pros and cons, and we'll discuss some of those later on. But basically, all of this is powered by the blockchain. And what is the blockchain? Well, there's different types of blockchain. So let's just take a look at what blockchain networks are. So here we can look on Cointelegraph at blockchain networks explained. Blockchain is a distributed, unchangeable ledger that makes recording transactions and managing assets, both tangible and intangible, in a corporate network much more accessible on a blockchain network. Virtually anything of value may be recorded and traded, lowering risks and cutting costs for all parties involved. But what are blockchain networks? Well, to put it simply, I'll explain how the Bitcoin blockchain works. If you go to the bank and you send money to someone else, that creates a transaction, and that transaction is recorded on, let's just say, the ledger, which for the sake of ease, let's just say it's like a piece of paper. Okay, so it's going to send that transaction from you to your friend, whoever you send your money to. Each transaction will then be recorded onto the ledger that goes through the bank. The bank then has control over that ledger and everything that happens on it, which is where the problem arises, because they can go in and change transactions if they so feel like it, which on a grand scale ultimately led to the financial meltdown in 2008. Now, blockchain is slightly different. In each ledger is basically a block on the blockchain, and at the end of the block you have a transaction which will then be put onto the next block and then create a chain. And because of this process, it means that you can't change individual blocks, and all of the different decentralized networks, which are based on all sorts of different places around the world, are accessing this same information. So all of that information is decentralized from one location, such as the bank, and is spread amongst many different people around the world. Therefore, everyone can see what transactions are going on, which means it can't be changed and it is ultimately secure. Now, obviously that's for transfer of value in terms of like monetary value through Bitcoin, but you can also do things like contracts. So that could be ownership of something like an NFT, which is a picture, but you can also do this for tickets, for events. You could do this for housing contracts. You could do this for effectively anything. And that is basically where Web3 is going, and it's a very exciting place because it's a trustless system. It doesn't rely on any middlemen or third parties, which is pretty much the ultimate benefit, because it reduces cost, it increases speed and efficiency, and that is where I see Web3's biggest benefits. Now, jumping across to internet computer, which is one of the places where we're seeing huge development in Web3, you'll understand a bit more about what Web3 has to offer us. Now, at the moment, the internet is built onto different clouds servers, such as the Amazon Web Service, such as Google Cloud Servers, and that means that there is a huge monopoly on the internet. That means that whenever you're creating data, those companies have access to your data and they can then sell it on. They can then go in when you're advertising a product and they can go in and compete and make it cheaper for them and more expensive for you. That is a massive, massive problem with Web2. And this is a $3.9 trillion problem worldwide each year, whereas internet computer is coming to save the day by allowing you to build directly onto the internet through a smart contract. That means that you can go in and anyone can go in and create all sorts of decentralized applications, all sorts of amazing different things. In the same way that you have Facebook, you have WhatsApp, you have all of these now being built on decentralized applications, which gives everyone access to being able to use any information they want without all the expensive charges. Also, you will start to get paid rewards for providing your own data, for watching different videos, and all these different things that at the moment are being monopolized by some of these enormous companies. This makes the internet much faster, much cheaper, and much more efficient, because it doesn't rely on any third-party trust. Now, this is great for so many reasons, but there would be a potential downside in this. Now, at the moment, there is control over what you can upload onto the internet, because people can upload things on Facebook doesn't necessarily mean that they deserve to be on Facebook. And in the past, we've seen people doing some pretty awful things around the world, such as terrorist attacks and stuff, which have been uploaded onto Facebook. But luckily, Facebook can then step in and remove that as quickly as possible. And in a Web3 world, this is potentially an issue because it may mean that there is a lack of control in general over what is posted, which obviously is a double-edged sword. There's obviously benefit to that in some ways, but there's also potentially huge problems with no one being in the middle to vet any issues. You could also potentially see a rise transferring of funds for illicit goods such as drugs, trafficking, and various others, which could be more problematic. So it's a bit of a double-edged sword. Web3, I think, is a great thing in general. For the majority of reasons, I think Web3 is a phenomenal technology going forward, and it's going to absolutely change the way in which we do things. It's going to be really beneficial for the average user, but there will be potentially some issues that come out from it. Let me know down below what you think in the comments. Do me a favor, if you enjoyed today's video, hit the like button. If you're new to the channel and you want to learn more about Web3, NFTs, crypto, and much, much more, then hit subscribe. Be kept up to date with all the latest happening. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.